Having worked with Bruce Barker in the past, one thing that sticks out in my mind is his contagious smile. Recently, the voice of the Toronto Rock suffered a stroke, and we had the chance to speak with family members and friends who wanted to send their well wishes as Bruce begins his road to recovery.
This is a huge game tonight.
Barksy means a lot to the guys. I know, like for myself, he's kind of created a cheer for the fans to kind of yell my name and stuff. So that doesn't get lost on the players, kind of what he does for us.
Bruce is just one of the most kind and loving and giving people you could possibly meet.
Bruce is a ball of energy. When he comes down the hall and into the ACC, you know he's there. I mean, he just has this commanding presence and an insane smile that literally warms up the room. It sounds cliche, but he just makes people happy to be around him. And the fact that he loves the team and the game so much, it's pretty inspiring.
Friends and family of Bruce Barker describe him as energetic, kind, and a true fan of the National Lacrosse League. Bruce has called over 250 National Lacrosse games, even receiving a letter from Prime Minister Justin Trudeau this year congratulating him on this feat. Those who know Bruce know that there's nothing that makes him happier than getting fans excited up in the booth.
I've often said he would bag groceries to make a living if he was interacting with people. But don't take the Rock away from him. Don't take the National Lacrosse League away from him, because that's what he loves to do.
Bruce brings his big smile and big laugh to every Toronto Rock home game.
Just seeing him around, and he's always got that positive spirit, positive energy, and you know, it's a little bit like, you know, just that familiarity and that, you know, it's a little bit comforting, even though hearing his voice.
But as the Toronto Rock open up their season this year, one big smile was missing. A few weeks ago, Bruce suffered a stroke and was devastated that he would miss the beginning of the season.
He was really, really sad when he knew he couldn't do the season opener. But we talked to Mike Hancock and we said, you know, we're going to really work on being back. And Mike said, well, we're just keeping your chair warm for you. And you do the work and it's waiting here for you, and your fans are waiting here, and all the guys love you, and we've gotten a huge amount of support.
Now Bruce is on the road to recovery, using Toronto Rock scripts to work on his speech.
Make some noise for the boys.
And while there's a long road ahead of him, knowing that he has the entire Toronto Rock team behind him and supporting him makes each step a little easier.
Hopefully he'll be back soon, but yeah, I mean, we will miss his energy that he brings. You know, he's been with us now for a while here.
We hope that he's back as soon as possible, and the guys will you know, I'm going to be thinking of him, be thinking positive thoughts.
The support has been so incredible, friends even started a GoFundMe to help raise money for Bruce's medical bills.
I've often said that Bruce is one of the kindest men I've ever known, and he's very humble, and I don't know if he believed that. And we are so thankful, and the generosity has meant everything to us. But what I've seen it do for Bruce is I've seen him now really be able to calm himself and now just focus on recovery.
Bruce is determined to be back cheering on his team, his family, this season. On behalf of the entire National Lacrosse League, we are wishing you a speedy recovery. For NLL Productions, I'm Mia Gordon.